I think this is a very important to know. Whoever are coming to Thailand right now from April, June, July, sometime around here, which is at the beginning of when Thailand is starting to open, you need to know and you need to understand about the hotel quarantine system. I don't want you to miss this video. Please watch, please. Sawasdee ka. It's me, Teya Sujira. If you want to know more about Thailand, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you will not miss anything about my country. I'm very happy for you about the previous video that we finalized that we do a quarantine for 7 days, 10 days, and 14 days, which is depending on where you're from and every condition, which you can have a look in the information in my previous video again. But however, nothing is easy, of course. This is Thailand. It's just because of when you are coming here, especially for you guys who are really coming here after you get a vaccine for 2 doses already, and you already after the 2 doses is already fully 2 weeks of 14 days, and you can be ready to fly here and you can do a quarantine for 7 days. For those of you who can't quarantine for 7 days, but about the hotel booking is not that easy. The thing is, I mentioned with you before in a previous video about the timing of your flight arrival. Because if you arrive here between midnight until 6 o'clock in the evening, it's going to be called that day as the day one. And if you arrive here after 6 p.m. until midnight, they're going to count the next day as the day one. This kind of complicated, it makes hotel people and the booking system get like, oh my god, how do I know? This problem, it makes you and the hotel business have to figure out how you can count if you will stay for 7 nights or 8 nights. So right now they decide to let you who are coming here, whether you're coming here for a quarantine for 7 days or 10 days for a person who haven't done a vaccinate yet, you have to pay first for 10 days quarantine. Why? It's just because the system of the 7 days quarantine, you're going to be checked first when you arrive the airport in Bangkok or any other destination in Thailand. Once when you arrive here, all the documents that they require you to see, for example, they will check if you did a vaccine for real, 2 doses for real, what kind of vaccines you got, everything like that. And if it's totally approved, they're going to tell you how many nights of the quarantine you are going to have. But however, everything, you know what vaccine you do and everything, if you know exactly, you would have to definitely do a quarantine for only 7 days. The last thing is about your arrival flight that they're going to tell you if you will be called the day your arrival as a day one or the day zero. That is what the officer at the airport going to inform the hotel again. So what the hotel can do is they will just block the room, even though you just do a quarantine for 7 days, but they have to block the room for you as a 10 days extra, just because of they don't know how many days exactly you have to stay. They will find it out until when they see you at the airport, and the officer at the airport, they're going to inform to the hotel like, okay, this customer, they are going to stay at your hotel finally. It's going to be in 8 nights, for example. And then after that, the process of the quarantine is going to be start. Even though you already got a vaccine, but the reason that they want you to do a quarantine in a hotel is just because they want to make sure that this vaccine is really work. It's just because right now it's still during the urgent vaccine. So they want to make sure that these vaccines really work. So they're going to check the COVID-19 test with you. And I'm going to write for you again that which day you're going to be tested. Quarantine, which is right now is like it's slightly more relaxed compared with at the beginning when Thailand opened people to come here and do a quarantine. You just have to stay in the hotel room for many days. But this one, when you arrive the hotel, you will not be allowed to just go out anywhere, just only inside the hotel. Not like that. You have to be in your room for 3 days. Because the first day that they're going to do the test, and after you do a test for the first time, you are going to allowed to be outside for the activities. And another one you need to know is the activities that they allow you to do. It's not that, oh, freely anywhere, you can go anywhere. You have to inform to the hotel that you would like to go to do some activities that that hotel have. For example, that hotel have some swimming pool. You have to call, you would like to go to the swimming pool, and they're going to see, okay, this time is available, you can go. Okay, just because of the each hotel has just specific space, and if they let everyone who do a quarantine to come to swimming pool at the same time, can you imagine? It's going to be high risk, even though people get a vaccine, and some people who haven't got a vaccine, they also would be part of that hotel. For example, a person who stay in that hotel for 14 days, if they come from 11 countries of the new strain of the COVID-19, and some of them are a person who are not vaccine yet, but they also do a quarantine in the same hotel as you, and you are the one who got a vaccine. Can you imagine if everyone just come to the swimming pool at the same time? How would you feel? I would feel a bit not quite sure if it's really safe. That's one of the reasons why you will be allowed by the timing. Just wanted to keep still social distancing in each hotel. And each person, they're going to allow to do activities between 45 minutes to hours to an hour, it depending on the hotel policy. How the difference between a hotel policy? I think this is my opinion. It depends on the size of the hotel. If they're 3-star hotel, 4-star hotel, 5-star hotels, they probably have different flexibility. different facility. Some hotel probably have no swimming pool. They only do a gym. You can do the gym, or they have the space for you to take a sit outdoor and read a book, that kind of things. So I would like to recommend you, before you make a booking at any hotel, if you have any question, please make a list of every question you want to know. And then after you know all the answer, then you can make a decision of booking with that hotel, okay? And also some of you think that the price of the hotel is expensive. I agree with you, it's expensive because during the pandemic, they're not allow every hotel to let you stay. Whoever wants to be part of ASQ or Alternative State Quarantine Hotel, they have to be approved by a Ministry of Public Health for the safety, if the air condition flow, and also the Ministry of Interior, they have to see if it's safe building, everything before they let you come and stay for quarantine. So it means that cheap hotel, or not every hotel, for example, not every hotel, they wanted to be part of the ASQ, or even expensive hotel, they don't want to be part of the quarantine hotel. It's just because of so many rules, and they probably feel like it's not worth it for them to be part of this business. But many hotels just wanted to have some work to do, even though they have very little low income, but it's better than nothing. I think at the moment, people who have a bit a problem with the tourism business, they have to think like that. So the price that when you book, even though it's the same hotel, but for sure, the price that you're going to pay during the coming here in the COVID-19 pandemic, you're not going to pay the same price. It's just because of this price is going to include with the transfer. Because when you are picked up at the airport, they're going to pick you up by their car, by their van. And a van has to be clean, just like exactly like during pandemic, not like easygoing, not like that. They have to protect and make sure you safe and the driver is safe from COVID-19 from each other. And also, when you arrive the your room, you will not be allowed to go out. So of course, it's going to be food, three meals food including, and another kind of services. You have to check with each hotel because price is different and service is different. But they also have to include with the COVID-19 test during you are staying in the hotel. So that's why it has some cost. So you can order food from outside, but however, you have to check with the hotel again that what kind of restaurant, which restaurant you can book and order food. Otherwise, you can order food in a hotel. This is now what you have to ask each hotel for policy as well. However, since April, Thailand is expected to have a lot of more tourists to come here, even though it's not going to be a lot, but hopefully more of you guys will be here. So this is a beginning of the when Thailand is starting to reopen the country slowly, just like a door you just slowly open. It's not gonna be so ready, just like a restaurant. When you have a restaurant and our restaurant is not really ready with the decoration, a painting and everything yet, but we have to open on this day. Nothing is perfect, so we have to fix everything, and hopefully after April, June, July, or after this, it's going to be easier after we starting to practice and everyone understand all the policy, both people who work in Thailand and also a person who just flying to Thailand as well. So I feel very bad. I feel very embarrassed. Yeah, I feel embarrassed about the system of the all the confusion. And whoever I talk, anyone who work in this business, no matter what kind of work, for all the about quarantine, tourism, these kind of things, it seems like everyone feel like because it keep changing. And I get some sources from some people tell me that when you hear the news today in the morning, afternoon, they change. I mean, the policy change. So they keep changing. That's why now I don't feel much guilty. I don't feel so guilty when in the past time that I gave you very confusing news, it's just because of the, it's really confusing in that kind of business as well. So I feel like I have friend, everybody all confused. Anyway, I hope that it's going to be better. But as I told you that I feel embarrassed, it's just because of you probably think like, hey, why do you charge us 10 days? I only stay only 7 days. Why do we have to pay for 10 days? Well, this is not quite professional, I accept it. But I understand as well that it's very confusing. And I heard that some hotel, they don't want to be headache with this kind of complicated. They would just only charge you 10 days. Okay? Some hotel, they want to be fair with you. They don't mind to be headache with this. So they don't mind to block the extra nights for you, and they don't mind that even though you have to stay less than that day, and they don't mind to refund cash when you check out. So you have to recheck carefully before you make a decision. If you feel like, okay, I don't care about the money that I'm going to pay, is easier and I don't have to make a lot of question, you can pay 10 days, just do it. But if you feel that you want to be fair, you want to pay what you have to pay fairly, so you have to go get through with this complication together with the hotel and also yourself. But hopefully, if you know more, you would understand, and they would definitely refund money to you if you, at the end you only stay for 7 nights or 8 nights. They're going to refund cash when you check out. So you will just get money back. That is all. They only want to take money for 10 days first I'm talking about people who just stay for 7 days, okay? Any of you who knows that you have to stay for 10 days, you will not have to be this headache. But 7 days quarantine, you're going to be more headache than other people. Sorry. But anyway, this is the information that I want to tell you first, and I'm going to make this video as the different episode, because next episode I'm going to tell you price of the hotel quarantine, whether Bangkok, Phuket, or anywhere. So first of all, I want you all to understand about this policy first, and then you, after you understand about this complication, and then you can accept it, you can see the next video about the price of each hotel quarantined. If you have any questions, you can write email to me. My email is going to show in the description under this. And then Stella is going to answer email to you. And if you would like to book the ASQ hotel with me to support me and Stella, you can tell her how much price you want to pay and everything. And then she will search for the best and suitable for you. And SMS, if you want to buy insurance for traveling here, which is a must, you have to apply COE, and you need to have insurance which is cover COVID-19. If you would like to support me and Stella, you also can buy with us. Otherwise, you are more than welcome to just write email, and if you need any help, you can write email to me, but please, no video call. Thank you so much for all the beautiful kind words that you support me and Stella in a previous video as well. Stella is very impressed because she never been in a video and show her face to you, but she's appreciated that she's part of this channel, and I hope you appreciated her work as well. Anyway, this is all about complicated information, and hopefully next video is going to be better than this. And if you like my video today, please give me a thumb up, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. I need 50 50 subscribers. Please share if it's useful, share to your friends, and I would love to have 50 only. And if you appreciated my information today, you feel like you want to support my channel, you want to buy me a coffee, you can have a look in the description how to buy me a coffee. And for today, thank you so much for watching until the end. Oh, before I go, I want to say thank you for a sponsor for my beautiful colorful dress to Nong On Fashion Costume. And thank you, and see you next time. Bye bye. Sawadee ka.